Hey mate, it's me. Who would have thought it? You're actually going away. I honestly thought when you met Chloe, it would never happen. But you're doing it, mate. You're doing it. So fair play to you. Yeah, it's been a hell of a ride. Come back soon so we can have plenty more adventures. I'm just going to leave you with this. Three little things which really sum this up. But yeah, grapes, ironing boards, and cooking. We love you, we miss you, and come back soon, man. Roll the footage.
You may have seen already on YouTube Channel 1 and YouTube Channel 2, Chef Michael and Chef Niall already do their cooking expertise. Today, we shall move on to Series 2.
Woo!
After a long break, we have Chef Niall, say
hello!
Woo! Chef Michael, say hello! And we shall do Chef Judy Cook.
Woo!
So today, what are we doing, Chef Michael?
Hold on, I'm buzzing. No, I'm sorry.
He's buzzing.
We are.
What are we doing, Chef
Michael? Well, we've got some horse food.
We have oats.
An egg.
Golden vegetable cup of shit.
And yes. Hot water.
Not a shit we'll find around the
place. Right. We also have Cosmo, which we bought 72 pint cans for.
Yeah, someone jacked it. You must remember today, it is Easter holidays.
No,
so we shall have an Easter theme.
No, it's not Easter holidays, it is Good Friday.
It is Good Friday. And what do we have now? We have
cooking time.
Cooking time. We have cooking time today. They're getting the kitchen ready and we shall explore what they have in the kitchen. So they have oats and a bowl.
Yeah, if you'd like to come closer, you can tell what we're actually doing.
We've got the oats. Mainly for horses, but we're not horses, so we're just going to
see what happens. That's brilliant. So, remember, Niall is an international chef.
Yes, exactly, 200 grams. How did you do that?
And here's the thing, after that,
we
have some golden soup.
Yes.
That's the place here. We open it up, probably. I guess we...
Yes.
We look at the technique of which he pours it in.
Oh,
look at the technique.
But Niall, we're missing one more thing. We're missing.
What are we missing?
An egg.
They're missing an egg.
An
you
egg.
Shall watch from there.
An egg.
Okay, now we have to be quick because we get the brand.
Yes,
that's good.
Now,
the
egg.
We have
a boiled kettle with an egg in
the boiled kettle.
Steaming hot water.
Run, boy, run. This world is not meant for you. Run, boy, run. They're trying to catch you. Run, boy, run. Running is a victory. Run, boy, run. Beauty lies behind the hill.
I lived with Michael for a few months and I managed to see the inner workings of his room, and you would think in a personal bedroom that they would have a picture of their, you know, something that they love or someone that they love. And in Michael's case, the someone that he loved, we managed to find this in his room, nicely framed.
Have fun abroad, you Brentford QPR cunt. Bye!
Oh, is another day, hey. You don't have to hide away, yeah. You'll be my boy. But for now it's time to run, it's time to run.
Hello mate, Jeff here. Hope you have a great time in Oz. We're all gonna miss you, of course. Hope you find a nice lady for yourself. Enjoy mate, peace, bye.
Michael, the only QPR fan I've ever met that I've actually liked. Sorry I can't be with you to say farewell before your trip, but have a fantastic time. Be safe, don't do anything I wouldn't do, and hopefully at some point I'll see you when you're back. Take care, mate.
Good luck in Australia, Mike. Hope it all goes well. Remember, there's two teams in Melbourne, a bit less than there is in London. I'm sure you can get around most of the A-League and claim at least one club of your own. Good luck, mate.
You will not like Australia. You will hate it. It's country full of people that just scowl at you and shorten words, taking two O's out of good for good day. You won't survive.
Tomorrow is another day, hey, when the night fades away.
best friend ever, woo, is right next to me. I've known him since I'm 4 years old. Hey Mike, how you doing?
Hi. I like grapes.
He likes grapes, apparently. That's awesome. What else you got to say?
I like grapes.
So we've known each other for like 26 years now, and we realised that we like grapes without pips.